friends, welcome to Citykidz. I'm so glad to have you here. Now it's time for us to sing and worship God together. We are going to be singing a song called Jesus Is. All right, so let's worship God together now.
So, when you hear what I say and you think I'm correct, you stand up. Well, if you think I'm wrong, you sit down. Right, okay. So let's try. Let's do an example first. Babies ride bicycles. Am I saying you're standing up? You're supposed to be seated because babies don't ride bicycles. Do you get the game now? So let's go. Let's try. This time we're going to be faster. Spiders have 5 legs. Spiders have 5 legs. How many legs do spiders have? Is anybody sitting down? Correct! Yes, spiders have 8 legs. Spiders don't have 5 legs. They have 8. Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good job! Good job. Let's try this last one. Let's try. Candies are sweet. Yes, we are all standing because yes, candies are sweet. And so today, in today's lesson, we are going to be learning about things that are true and things that are false. So you know, when I said babies ride bicycle, Do babies ride bicycle? Of course not. So you know that is false. And when I said candies are sweets, was that correct? Exactly, yes, that was correct. So that is exactly what we'll be learning today. Things that are true and things that are false. I'll see you right back.
Hi friends, it's me, Megan, and my name is Jessie. Megan, what time is it?
There's a clock. Looks like it's about 10:35.
Oh, man.
What?
Where is he?
Where is who?
The mail carrier. He always comes at 10:30, and he is late today.
I've never known you to care about when the mail arrives, Jessie.
I'm usually not, but today is different. My grandma sent me a surprise in the mail. She said it should arrive today. I can't wait.
Oh, fun. That is very exciting.
What time is it now, Megan?
It's 10:36, Jessie. Only 1 minute since you last asked.
Oh, sorry.
That's okay. I have an idea. Why don't we listen to today's Bible story while you wait? The believers in Thessalonica were waiting too. Listen to this story. Paul had traveled to the city of Thessalonica. The people there worshipped idols, things that were not God. Some of them even worshipped the leader of Rome. Paul told the people about Jesus, and many of them believed. Paul started the church in Thessalonica, but not everyone liked Paul or his teaching about Jesus. They made him leave the city. Paul worried about the believers in Thessalonica. They had not been believers for very long. So Paul sent his friend Timothy to visit them. Timothy brought back happy news. Even though following Jesus was not easy, the believers did not give up. Paul wrote a letter to encourage the believers. He told them that Jesus will come back someday. On that day, believers will not suffer anymore. This message gave the believers hope. Paul wrote to the church in Thessalonica, "We want you to know what is true. We believe that Jesus died and rose again." Paul said that believers who die before Jesus comes back will not miss out. When Christians die, Jesus takes them to be with him. When Jesus comes back, he will bring with him the Christians who died, and we will live with him forever. Paul wrote, "No one knows when Jesus will come again, so we should always be ready." The prophets in the Old Testament told about the day when God would judge the world and save his people. Paul said that in the future, Jesus will come back for his people and judge the wicked. Believers can live with hope because Jesus will come again.
Did you enjoy the story? Well, I'm going to tell you a story. But this story is actually from the lesson. So, story. Once upon a time, there were certain people called the Thessalonians. What did I call them? The Thessalonians. And so these people did not believe in Jesus Christ. They were serving other gods. In fact, they were serving people. And Paul, I know that name sounds familiar already. Yes, Paul went to the people of Thessalonians and told them about Jesus Christ. And the people of Thessalonians believed and they all wanted to serve Jesus. But something happened. Some people did not like what Paul was saying. And so you know what they did? The same thing anyway. Can you imagine? And so when Paul left the people of Thessalonians, he was now worried that how will the people of Thessalonians continue to believe in Jesus if there is nobody there to continue to encourage them. And so you know what? Paul sent Timothy to the people of Thessalonians and asked Timothy to go and check them and see how they are doing. And guess what? I have good news. Yes, Timothy, when he got to Thessalonians, the people that believed still believed in Jesus Christ. They had not forgotten what Paul had told them. And then Paul wrote to them, giving them hope He told them that Jesus Christ is going to come back and take us home. How many of you believe that Jesus Christ is coming back? I believe. Yes, I believe. And I know you believe too that Jesus is coming back. In fact, that is the whole essence of this Christianity. The fact that Jesus Christ is coming back to take us home. Well, this is to say that we should not lose hope because we know that Jesus Christ is coming back again. And that is what is true, just like what we played before, right? Great. So remember the game that we played while we're trying to learn what is true or what is false? Yes. So Paul was trying to tell the people of Thessalonians what was true, that Jesus Christ is going to come back again. But you know what's amazing about this? We don't know when Jesus is going to come back, so we always have to live ready. So I want to test your readiness. Are you ready? Are you ready? Yes. So we're going to play a dance freeze game. I need you all to stand up. Everybody stand up, stand up. Yes. So when you hear the song play, you have to dance. And the moment you hear the song stop, you stop. Okay, so let's go. Ah, that was a lot. Please, how many of you got it right? Were you not dancing when you're not supposed to be dancing? Well, and you know that, okay, so while you were trying to get when I was going to stop or when I was going to dance, you were not exactly sure, or were you? Exactly, that is the way God wants us to be ready. He wants us to be ready for Him when He comes back. So, that's what Paul was trying to tell the Thessalonians, that when they come, when Jesus Christ comes, they are supposed to be ready. So, let's pray. Our Father and our God, we want to thank you for today's lesson. We want to thank you for helping us to know what is true and what is false. We ask that you help us to know you more. We ask that you help us to believe, and we ask that you help us be ready for when you come back again. In Jesus' name we are prayed. Amen.
Just like your teacher said, believers can live with hope because Jesus is coming back again. Now, we've come to the end of today's class, but we can't move on without reciting our memory verse for the month. Can you remember which book it's from in the Bible? Let me give you a clue. Starts with letter A, and then the next letter is C, and then T, and then S. The book of Acts, chapter 4, verses 12. Can you repeat it after me? There is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given to people by which we must be, let's say, saved together. Saved. All right, now you're going to continue learning it through a memory verse song. And have a wonderful, wonderful, great, good, nice, awesome week. See you next week.